Someone that sells cars for a living. I've been in the car sales for 7 years now, And although I didn't start, I wasn't full time. For the first 4 years, I dabbled into it per month, but I never went all out. But in March 2014, I quit my full time job and went straight into car sales. It's not really been easy because, like, for a year after that, I spent a whole lot of time in mechanic workshops, going to Ladenburg. It's a lot because you first say, me again. Or rather, on the phone, when people call me, you see my online ads and, like, just call and say, I saw this paper online. And when I reply, they're like, sorry, this is a woman's voice. And I'm like, yeah, I sell cars. And they're like, I'm sorry, I've not seen that one before. And then sometimes when if it's a woman that is calling, when they hear my voice, they are more comfortable. But guys, they're a bit skeptical. And so that's when we see, it's like, okay, fine. When we see, it's a bit, oh, this is new. And if I impress them, I think we continue on the business. I don't want to sound tribalistic yet, but I think I have lost one or two, but over the phone, it's not like they saw me physically. People may be apprehensive because, one, there's a whole lot of spam everywhere and nobody wants to call and go abuse a woman. Maybe there's someone that wants to come and collect my money somewhere and buy me and all that. But I think it was more of the scam, because of the scam part of it, not even because I was a woman. Being able to do things differently. Whatever, anybody can sell cars. Anybody can actually be in construction. But as a woman, when you're entering something that is being dominated by men, it's usually better to come with a different approach. For example, if someone sells, everybody can sell pure water, but there's one that advertises online that has a different approach. So for me, I've always thought that when breaking into something that is unconventional, you need to have a whole lot of unconventional approaches. You need to make sure that you have better customer service. Your client retention techniques must be on point. That's what it is, really, because nobody will take you seriously. First, they will laugh at you, and you need to give them a reason why they should trust you with their money and trust your own skill set. So I've thought of more than another, I've had to work harder.